with 3 jihadis dead and 2 jihadis jailed in attempts to kill me, behead me, since my free speech event in Garland, Texas last May, the Southern Poverty Law Center's designation of me as an Islamophobe and a hatemonger is just encouraging jihadis to come and kill me or behead me and the other women that this communist hate group names. At a time when jihad killers are moving actively against those whom they hate in the United States, this is quite literally a hit list. If any of the people named on the SPLC list are attacked or killed by jihadists, the Southern Poverty Law Center ought to be shut down and prosecuted for incitement to murder. Not that such a thing is likely to happen in Obama's America. Obama will probably send the SPLC a letter of commendation the week after the killing, as he did with the Oklahoma mosque after a congregant beheaded a coworker there. But consider this. The SPLC lists my organizations as hate groups. AFDI, the American Freedom Defense Initiative, is a human rights organization dedicated to freedom of speech, freedom of conscience, and individual rights. This is designated as a hate group by a vicious, uber-left, pro-jihadist organization, widely cited, mind you, by the media and Obama's Department of Justice. My group is a human rights group, but the Nation of Islam has been removed from SPLC's hate group list. This is the morally inverted state of the world. The SPLC is not a group dedicated to the defense of human rights. It's a hard left attack machine. Vets, patriots, and freedom's defenders are all in its crosshairs. Even presidential hopeful Ben Carson was on its list for some time. Even worse, members of the SPLC have committed domestic terrorism crimes. Yeah. Several years ago, Southern Poverty Law Center member Floyd Corkins stormed the Family Research Council's headquarters in Washington, D.C. and began shooting. Why? Because the FRC was designated a hate group by the Southern Poverty Law Center. Corkins shot at a security official in the arm, who managed to wrestle Corkins to the ground before he could kill or injure anyone else. Family Research Council President Tony Perkins said at the time that Corkins was given a license to shoot an unarmed man by organizations like the Southern Poverty Law Center that have been reckless in labeling organizations as hate groups because they disagree with them on public policy. The SPLC is a dangerous subversive organization that partners with Islamic supremacist groups and other treasonous groups to destroy America from within. A DOJ official praises the Southern Poverty Law Center's work in combating domestic terrorism, but its members are domestic terrorists. The communists over at the Southern Poverty Law Center are among the gravest threats to freedom to the United States. They are a wellspring of manufactured hate and are named as such in the AFDI Threats to Freedom Index. Who watches the watchmen? Who appointed this vicious group the arbiter of what is hate and what isn't? Why is fighting for the freedom of speech and equality for all before the law now classified as hate? An uncritical and uninformed public takes for granted that the SPLC is some kind of a neutral observer, when actually it uses its hate group classifications to stigmatize and demonize foes of its nefarious political agenda. America, it's time to wake up.